Hello everyone. My name is Evgeny. I'm a data engineer at Medvedev. And in this session, I will talk about how we build the Etheruem dataset in Google BigQuery. So here is how this talk is structured. In the introduction, I will first give you some context about cryptocurrencies and Etheruem. And I will also introduce you to our project, Etheruem ETL. Then in the second part, I will describe our architecture and I will show you how you can use Google services, cloud composer and BigQuery. And lastly, I will spend some time showing you how you can use cloud WhatsApp, data flow and cloud functions to enable real-time data processing and analysis. So let's begin with the context. What is Etheruem, what is ETL, and what is Etheruem ETL? Etheruem is a platform based on blockchain technology. Like its predecessor Bitcoin, you can think of it as an immutable distributed ledger. It has transactions. These transactions are grouped into blocks, and the blocks are organized into a chain, a blockchain. Every new block references the one behind it, and that's how the blockchain is formed in simple words. But unlike Bitcoin, Ethereum is much more than just a ledger. It also includes a virtual machine that can run arbitrary code. This code is stored on the blockchain as smart contracts. They enable programmatic creation of agreements, so things like paying a monthly rent can now be programmed and executed on the blockchain instead of being written on a paper contract and enforced by law. Another application of smart contracts, which is quite popular recently, is tokens, which can be easily created by anyone. Every token is basically a currency, and the creator of a token can define the rules of how this currency is emitted, destroyed, transferred, and a lot more. All of this data, clocks, transactions, smart contracts live in the Etheruem network. Unfortunately, there is no easy way to analyze this data with the API that Etheruem plans to provide. For example, a simple task like finding the biggest transaction would require you to download and scan the entire blockchain. This is very hard to do on a laptop, for example, given the current number of transactions. Here's where Etheruem ETL comes into play. ETL stands for extract, transform, and load. It's simply moving data from one data source into another. And Etheruem ETL is a set of tools for moving Etheruem blockchain data into interactive query engines, such as Google BigQuery. It's also a system currently running in production that ingests live Etheruem data to BigQuery. You can access the code, it's all open source on GitHub. So I decided to start this project because I saw the need to analyze Ethereum blockchain data and I couldn't find any tools or services that could do it. So many services, they could do standard analysis like they plot transaction volume over time or they show mining hash rate, but they didn't give you access to the raw Ethereum data so that you could query it with SQL. So me and Anandey from Google decided to set up a project in GCP that ingests Ethereum data and we released the public data set in BigQuery. So here's how the system works. The ingestion pipeline is divided into two phases, export and load. They are coordinated by Google Cloud Composer, which you can see here at the top. Cloud Composer is a fully managed workflow orchestration service built on Apache Airflow. In the export phase, the blockchain data, blocks, transactions, tokens, is exported into CSV files and saved into file storage. And in load phase, these files are got processed, loaded into BigQuery, and finally verified. Then you can query this data with standard SQL in BigQuery console. Okay, now I would like to show you a little bit of Cloud Composer. I will quickly walk you through the process of creating a new environment so you have a sense of how easy it is to set up and use. So you just go to Google Cloud Console. In the Big Data section, you choose Composer. When you create a new environment, you specify its name, the number of nodes, and other optional data. When the environment is created, you need to upload workflow definition files. They are called tags in Airflow, which stands for Directed Acyclic Graph. So when you click on this tags thing, you will be redirected to cloud storage, where you can upload the tag definitions. They have to be written in Python. So here, for example, you can see in Ethereum ECL project, we have export tag, load tag, and in the middle lines tag, which is used for monitoring the environment. After you've done this, you can access the Airflow console, which Cloud Composer provided for you. And the DAGs will be automatically picked up from the cloud storage. So here again, you can see export, load, and live DAG. So these DAGs are currently running daily. Well, for example, you can see that export DAG ran 1,170 something times. So this means how many days ago the first Ethereum block was mined. Airflow also gives you various views on the DAGs, which you can access from these links on the right. For example, this is how the graph view looks like for the export DAG. The exporting process is divided into steps for each particular piece of data. For example, blocks and transactions are exported first, then the CSV files moved into cloud storage. Then receipts and logs are exported, given as input transaction hashes exported on the previous step. Receipts in Ethereum are basically results of transaction executions. So things like transaction status, gas use, and blue filter fields in the receipt. And I will tell you later what gas is in Ethereum. And logs are basically events emitted by smart contracts. They're used for filter and search functionality. So imagine there is a new token transfer, and you want to find only, there are several token transfers, and you want to find the ones that are sent to or from your address. So you would use logs for this. And similarly, token transfers are exported, given as input receipts exported on the previous step. And so on. This view shows how long it takes to export the data. Exporting the entire blockchain may take you several days, depending on how many nodes you have in your composer cluster. From this graph, you can also see that exporting receipts and logs takes the longest time. And the reason for this is that the API of the Ethereum client allows you to export receipts only one by one. In other words, you cannot export receipts, all receipts in a single log, unlike transactions, for example. And we already submitted an issue to the Ethereum project on GitHub to support it. It's currently work in progress. So this is Gantt view. It's very similar to the previous view. It just shows the task execution order and the duration. So again, here you can see that the receipts and logs takes the longest time. This view is called tree view. It's basically a matrix where in the rows there are tasks in the workflow, organized into a tree. And in the columns are the days on which these tasks run. So another challenge that we face while working on the project is how you can retrieve the block range for a data. So the thing is that for each day here, you want to export only the blockchain data that relates to this day. So you want to query the block range that covers only this particular day. And the problem here again is that the Ethereum client API don't allow this. And you can only query block by number, but you cannot query a block by a timestamp. So what I have to do is I have to use interpolation search. It's similar to the logarithmic search, but instead of dividing the range in halves, you use interpolation to find the point in which you divide this range, assuming that the distribution of the data is linear. So in this case, block numbers and timestamps, they are distributed linearly. Because new blocks, they mined every 13 seconds normally, with some exceptions. So for example, this graph, it has a timestamp on the x-axis, and it has blocks, block numbers on the y-axis. So as you can see, it looks linear mostly. So using an interpolation search here, speeds up the process a lot, so this algorithm runs in big O of log of like log of n, as opposed to logarithmic search that runs in log of n time. So after the export tag is finished, all the CSV files reside in the cloud storage, and then the load index is in. The load index is divided into four steps. First, it waits for the CSV files in the cloud storage, exported by the export tag. After that, it loads the CSV files into BigQuery tables. Then multiple tables are joined together to enrich the data. For example, we add block numbers, timestamps, and hashes to transactions table, token transfers, etc. And finally, the data is verified for consistency. For example, we check that there are no duplicated rows or there are no missing rows. And at the end, a notification email is sent. The result of the tags in Cloud Composer are tables in BigQuery dataset. So here you can see on the left, I show the tables in the dataset. Blocks, transactions, contracts, logs, etc. And on the right is the transactions table schema, the list of columns, the types, and descriptions. You can access this dataset by this URL in BigQuery console. All the data is public. The current size of the dataset is more than 300 gigabytes. But it, of course, it all resides in the cloud. So here's an example of a very simple query. It's written in standard SQL, as you can see, and it runs in just a few seconds. So this query retrieves transaction volume in Ether. So if you click this Explore in the Data Studio button, you will be able to visualize this data in Google Data Studio. So this is the data visualized. It's transaction volume in Ether. On this graph, for example, you can see that around March of 2018, the activity on the blockchain reduced significantly. And possible reason for this is that people maybe started to realize that there are many more fraudulent projects than genuine that try to raise money with ICOs. So that's just my hypothesis. Data Studio allows you to customize your graphs. So for example, that's the same graph but with different styling options. So here is an example of a more complicated query, which shows off a very powerful BigQuery feature. The ability to write user-defined functions in JavaScript and then use them in your SQL queries. So here, for example, you can see at the top the UDF defined. UDF stands for user-defined function. It references a JavaScript library which is stored in Google Cloud Storage. And at the bottom is the actual SQL query which uses this UDF function. The UDF is called disassembled bytecode. What it does is it queries bytecode at a particular Ethereum address and it disassembles it. So here's how bytecode looks like stored in the blockchain and in our dataset. It's just a sequence of bytes in hexadecimal form. And this is how the JavaScript function looks like. It disassembles the bytecode and outputs the machine commands. So this is the result of the SQL execution. It's the list of machine commands, which are also called opcodes in Ethereum. The result also includes the fees of commands in gas. So every operation in Ethereum virtual machine requires a different computational effort. And gas is the measure of this effort. When users want to execute smart contracts in Ethereum network, they have to pay for gas in Ether. So here, for example, you can see that jump I operation costs a little bit more than other operations. Jump I is equivalent to an if statement in higher order programming languages. And in Ethereum, there are operations that cost a lot more than this. For example, reading or writing from storage costs 20,000 gas, for example. And this is correlates with normal computers where reading and writing from storage normally is a much more expensive operation than doing something in the CPU. You can even disassemble all smart contracts in the dataset, and you can count which commands are the most frequent. So this query does this, and from the result you can see that push one and pop are the most frequent commands. Of course, it doesn't tell you much, but you can see how powerful BigQuery is. This query to disassemble all smart contracts in the Ethereum network ran in just 1 minute. So you can run this query yourself in BigQuery console if you would like. I see that no one likes it. Okay. So now is the final section of my talk. I would like to talk about the features we are currently working on. So this dataset in BigQuery is public, it's accessible, it's available to everyone. People can use it for analysis, but we would like to add more features to the project. So one of the features is real-time Ethereum notifications. What is it about? So imagine there is a new transaction on the blockchain and it somehow relates to you. For example, there are new tokens transferred to your address. So you will be able to receive notifications via Slack or email or any other communication channel. And moreover, you will be able to run any custom logic in cloud functions. For example, you might want to integrate it with your application somehow, like show this data on your website. Recall that that Ethereum data is ingested into BigQuery in a separate project, and then this data can be accessed by anyone. This is enabled by the ability to share data sets in BigQuery. In a similar way, you can create a WhatsApp topic and then share it for read access to everyone. So this diagram demonstrates this. On the left, it shows the ingestion project where the Ethereum data is streamed into the cloud WhatsApp topic. Then this WhatsApp topic is shared to everyone, and other people can subscribe to this topic in their own projects. and they can connect the subscriptions to cloud functions. This is a very cost-efficient way for the subscribers for two reasons. So first of all, they don't pay for the ingestion of the data. And secondly, GCP allows you to use PubSub and cloud functions for free up to some limit. So in our case, new Ethereum blocks are mined every 30 seconds, which adds up to 200,000 blocks per month, and this fits into the free tier of PubSub and cloud functions. So basically, in most cases, this setup will be free for subscribers. The same PubSub topic can be connected to BigQuery via Dataflow. Dataflow is a fully managed service that allows you to process data in streaming batch mode. With this in place, when you query the tables in BigQuery, the results will include live Ethereum data. It's important to note that you cannot simply replace the data in Airflow with data flow. And the reason for this is blockchain forks. This is a situation when there are multiple different chains that have the same parent block. So in this case, one part of the network will see one blockchain, and another part of the network will see another chain. But eventually only a single chain will be. But it's possible that the loosened chain was already streamed to PubSub, and as a result, the data in BigQuery will be invalid. So this can be fixed with the DAGs in Airflow, which lag behind the network by at least 1 hour. And in blocks, this old forks are almost impossible. Another reason why we need DAGs in Airflow is that streaming by its nature cannot provide strong enough consistency guarantees. So you may end up with duplicate or missing rows in query tables, which can be fixed with Airflow DAGs, which don't use streaming, they use batch loading. This approach is called Lambda architecture. When you use both streaming and batch processing to provide a view on the data. So streaming, it gives you access to online data, and batch processing, so streaming gives you access to online data which is not 100% accurate, and batch processing gives you access to 100% consistent data. The reason it's called Lambda is if you turn this picture 90 degrees, it looks like the stream is separated into two flows, so it resembles the Greek letter Lambda. So finally, I would like to encourage everyone to contribute to the project. As you see, we have many features. This project is supported by Ethereum Community Fund. They reward contributors with generous bounties. So the way it works is once the funding is requested, then the bounty will be attached to the issue on GitHub, and then the contributor who completes the task will be paid. So if you have experience with GCP and you want to learn more about Ethereum and you want to get rewarded for this, feel free to look around the repository and find a task that you want to tackle. We will appreciate it. That's it.
Anyone have a question? Okay, so maybe on, and do you still at the event during lunch? Okay, so we have more time with the speaker.
Yeah, feel free to ask me questions at lunch.
Thank you, Evgeny. ขอบคุณคุณ Evgeny นะครับจากความรัก